Good morning, everyone. I hope you're keeping well. We're gonna go straight into our psalm for this morning. It's Psalm 31. It's quite a long one, so we're gonna go straight into it and read it together. In you, O Lord, do I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your righteousness, deliver me. Incline your ear to me, rescue me speedily. Be a rock of refuge for me, a strong fortress to save me. For you are my rock and my fortress. And for your name's sake, you lead me and guide me. You take me out of the net they have hidden for me, for you are my refuge. Into your hand I commit my spirit. You have redeemed me, O Lord, faithful God. I hate those who pay regard to worthless idols, but I trust in the Lord. I will rejoice and be glad in your steadfast love, because you have seen my affliction. You have known the distress of my soul, and you've not delivered me into the hand of the enemy. You've set my feet in a broad place. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for I'm in distress. My eye is wasted from grief, my soul and my body also. For my life is spent with sorrow and my years with sighing. My strength fails because of my iniquity, and my bones waste away. Because of all my adversaries, I have become a reproach, especially to my neighbours, and an object of dread to my acquaintances. Those who see me in the street flee from me. I've been forgotten like one who is dead. I've become like a broken vessel. For I hear the whispering of many, terror on every side, as they scheme together against me, as they plot to take my life. But I trust in you, O Lord. I say, you are my God. My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from my persecutors. Make your face shine on your servant. Save me in your steadfast love. O Lord, let me not be put to shame, for I call upon you. Let the wicked be put to shame. Let them go silently to Sheol. Let the lying lips be mute, which speak insolently against the righteous in pride and contempt. Oh, how abundant is your goodness, which you have stored up for those who fear you, and worked for those who take refuge in you. In the sight of the children of mankind, in the cover of your presence, you hide them. From the plots of men, you store them in your shelter, from the strife of tongues. Blessed be the Lord, for he has wondrously shown his steadfast love to me. When I was in a besieged city, I said in my alarm, I'm cut off from your sight. But you heard the voice of my pleas for mercy when I cried to you for help. Love the Lord, all you his saints. The Lord preserves the faithful, but abundantly repays the one who acts in pride. Be strong and let your heart take courage, all you who wait for the Lord. It's a psalm set in a time full of stress and pressure, a time of trouble that the psalmist finds himself in, and that's been a common theme. We've seen that throughout the psalms that we've looked at, that these great works, these poems, emerge from these times of stress and difficulty and need for safety and deliverance. And really, Psalm 31 kind of sums up the approach of all of these kinds of psalms. That the ultimate solution, if you like, or the ultimate place to go when you're under this stress and this pressure, is to turn to God and to ask for rescue, to turn away from the idols that so many put their trust in, to turn away from the things that promise to satisfy and never come through on their promises, whatever those things are. And we can think of many idols during this time that have been toppled because we've realized we can't put our trust in those things. Those things can be taken away from us, pulled out from under us like a rug. And the only place to turn to is to God, to commit our spirits, our whole selves to him, and ask for his deliverance. In verse 8, it talks about how we're set in a broad place, in a spacious place, that they were taken away from the pressure, the narrowness, the claustrophobia of all of these dangers and stresses and pressures all around us. And we're set in a place where we can breathe, where there is space, where we can look around, where we can feel safe. And that is done because of what Jesus has done for us on the cross. Jesus has taken the ultimate pressure and stress on himself. He's taken the pressure of all of our sin and the pressure of all of our judgment. He's taken the pressure of our death for us. so that we can stand in a spacious place, so that we can stand in a place where we're free from the pressure of judgment, free from the fear of death. Because he said to God, into your hands I commit my spirit, we can know the grace and the deliverance that he offers us. Of course, times of trouble still come to us. And there will be times, perhaps whenever we feel like David does in the middle part of the psalm, where people, we feel, don't want anything to do with us, where people are scheming against us. But even those times are in his hands. When we sing the hymn based on this line in the psalm, my times are in your hand, do we really mean every time? The times that we go through that we never wanted to go through, that nobody would ever have wanted us to go through? Can we say, even those times, God, are in your hands, and you can use them? You can use them to bring something good. You can use them to rescue us. You can use them to deliver us. You can use them to vindicate us and show that our faith in you is not without foundation. You can use those times to do that, God. But you'll do it in your time. And so in the meantime, we wait. We wait in the knowledge, as the last part of the psalm from verse 19 onwards says, that God's abundant goodness will not fail us. It will not fail us. Even when we feel, as it says in verse 22, when we feel that we're cut off from him, when we feel that we don't know where he is, we don't know what he's doing, we don't know how long this will last, and we don't know what his purpose is, even when we feel that he's not there, the reality is that he's there, that our times are in his hand, that he hears our cries for mercy. He listens to our cries for help, and he will respond to us. As I was reading this psalm and thinking about it, and particularly the very last verse, it says, be strong and let your heart take courage, all you who wait for the Lord. My mind went back to, and I've used this illustration before, the moment in The Voyage of the Dawn Treader by C.S. Lewis, where there is darkness all around, where the folks on board the ship are panicking, their worst fears are being played over and over in their imaginations. And Lucy, one of the children, sees this albatross flying around the ship. And the albatross comes closer and closer and whispers to her, in the voice of Aslan, of course, courage, dear heart. And that's all she needs. And it's all we need, to hear the voice of God whispering to us in our stress, in our pressure, in all of the things we have to face and have had to face through this time. Courage, dear heart. I'm with you. I'm there. I won't fail. Take care. God bless.